Time for another youth video report, so...
We're living an extreme day, day.
Hey guys, hope everybody's having a great day today. It's a new week, it's Monday, and I know we are getting closer and closer to Christmas, and I hope you got all your shopping done and are in the process of getting it done. But anyway, that is part of the season, but as we know, the most important part of celebrating Christmas is celebrating the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and I hope that will be the main focus of your Christmas this year with your family. Anyway, guys, today I want to read a verse of Scripture to you from the Gospel of John, chapter 8, verses 10 and 11. It says this, "When Jesus had raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, 'Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?' She said, 'No one, Lord.' And Jesus said to her, 'Neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more.'" Now, you know this passage of Scripture. It comes from the story of the adulterous woman, where they brought this woman to Jesus and they said that, you know, under the law of Moses, and we found her in the very act of adultery, the law of Moses said that we are to stone such a person. Now, granted, the law of Moses, as it says in Deuteronomy, also says that the man should have been brought forward too and should have also been stoned, but they did not bring the man with her. They only brought this woman because their intent was not to harm this woman or to bring judgment upon her, but their intent was to judge Jesus and to try to get him to say, yes, we should kill her. And then they would run to the Romans and say, he is saying that we need to kill people, which goes against Roman law that we're not allowed to do. Or if he said that, no, you should let her go free, then he would be going against the law of Moses. And so they thought they had Jesus trapped. And so when he looked up at them in reply, he said, "He who is without sin cast the first stone at her." And so little by little, they all began to drop their rocks and walk away, feeling like, wow, Jesus just duped us again. I mean, no matter what we try to do, he always outsmarts us. But the most important part of this passage is what he says to the woman at the end when he asks her, "Where are those that accuse you?" And she looks up and says, "Well, wow, there's nobody left here that's accusing me." He says, "Neither do I condemn you. Go. And from now on, sin no more." I think we forget about that. I mean, Jesus didn't condone her sin, and he doesn't condone our sin, any kind of sin. Whether you agree with what the Bible says about sin or certain kinds of sin or not, the main thing is Jesus told her, "Go and sin no more. Do no more of this. Get out." You know, he could have told her, "Look, I know you've had a hard life, and I know you know, their times are tough. You got to do what you got to do to get by." But no, he could have said, "Hey, look, just be sure to watch out for those Pharisees because they're all hypocrites, so that they, you know, will leave you alone." No, he said, "Go and sin no more." And that's what he says to us. Listen, when we sin, when we make a bad choice, we repent of the sin, we move on past it, turn away from him, and turn towards God to sort of make our relationship, you know, good again with the Lord. Jesus loves us no matter what we do. He loved this woman, even in her sin. He loves us, even in our sin. That's why he's willing to go to a cross to die for all of us and die for our sins. Anyway, guys, I hope this helps. Listen, we don't have the right to judge people, as we've talked about many times. The Word of God does that, but sin is sin, no matter how you slice it, and we need to turn away from it and turn back to God. Anyway, have a great day. God bless you. We'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.